Hi, this is Asing. You are now watching Asing Math TV. In this video, we will learn how to obtain the mean and the standard deviation for a set of group data by using Casio calculator. If we are given class intervals as shown, what we have to do here is to first obtain the midpoint or the class mark for each class. For example, for the first class 0 to 2, to get the midpoint, we can take 0 plus 2 and divide it by 2 and we get 1. For the second class, we take 3 plus 5 equal to 8 and divide it by 2, we get 4, and so for the rest of the classes. Next, we press mode for 2 times to get the ST function. Then we just have to input the data according to x semicolon f, which means that for the first class we have 1, shift comma to get semicolon 5. Then we press n plus. The n equal to 5 here show we already have 5 observations. Next, the second class 4, semicolon 12, n plus, we have now 17 observations, which is 5 plus 12. Then next, we have 7, semicolon 20, n plus, and next, we have 10, semicolon 16, n plus. Next, 13, semicolon, 5, n plus. And the last class, we have 16, semicolon, 2, n plus. So we already obtained all the observations, 60 observations. Then we press AC. Next, to determine to get the value of the summation, for example, summation fx, we just have to press shift 1 to get the summation value, either for summation fx or summation fx squared. As we can see, the calculator did not show the letter f, but we have to bear in mind since this is grouped data, so which means that we have frequency, we have to apply this formula. So we should refer to summation fx, which means that summation x number 2, that we press 2, and we will obtain the value 450, as we can see. So if let's say we want to obtain the summation fx square, shift 1 again, and we look for x square, so which is number 1. Remember to press equal button. So we have 4134. So next, if let's say we want to obtain the mean and also the standard deviation values, then we choose shift 2. So we have x bar number 1, which is the mean value, and we have 7.5, as we can see here. Then shift 2 again. For certain calculator, we will have these symbols, and for certain calculator will show sigma and s. Sigma stands for population standard deviation, S stand for sample standard deviation. And for this, we just have to refer to n and m minus 1. Recall that according to the formula that we have, total f is equivalent to n, the number of observations. So which means that summation f here is n, summation f here is n, and summation f minus n, which means that it's n minus 1. So this is exactly the same as this one, n minus 1. So if let's say we want to determine the sample value, then we just have to press 3. So we obtain 3.587 rounded to the nearest 3 decimal point. And for the population, shift 2 again, we just have to look for n without minus 1. So number 2, and we press equal, we will get the value that we want. Okay, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Hope you like this. See you.